In exact arithmetic, we now have an algorithm for actually computing the singular value decomposition. We can form the Hermitian matrix A, Hermitian A. We can then use the QR algorithm that we discussed last week to compute its spectral decomposition. And we can then, from V and from sigma, compute the unitary matrix U. We've seen before that the conditioning of a problem can take a small relative error in the input and amplify it into a large relative error in the output. And when we are dealing with matrices, it's the conditioning of the matrix, the condition number of the matrix, that dictates how that happens. Now, it turns out that the condition number of a matrix also impacts how relative error in the matrix gets amplified into the accuracy of the eigenvalues and eigenvectors that are computed. So that's a conditioning problem. The other problem is the algorithm that we're executing numerically stable? Now, it turns out that when you form A Hermitian A, well, we already saw this, that squares the condition number. Okay, and that should immediately send off alarm bells. It turns out that we can avoid computing A Hermitian A, and we can actually more directly compute our matrix U. And the algorithm that we're going to create, building on what we learned in the last week when it came to computing the spectral decomposition, that algorithm is again only going to cast all of its computation in terms of similarity transformations, unitary similarity transformations. Okay? And therefore we are going to get an algorithm that has all of the nice properties that we want.